Hey YouTube! Welcome back to Taylor Talks Tales. Got yet another book review for you guys today on a not super well-known book, I don't think. I haven't really heard too many people talking about this, so I figure I'll give it a review. And that is The Rains by Gregg Hurwitz. Cool cover. A little cheesy looking, but, you know, I liked it. Funny enough, I actually picked this up at the Minneapolis airport. I have this weird thing where I hate feeling like I am gonna run out of things to read. Whenever I go traveling, I always pack way too many books. Whenever I go anywhere, like, I pretty much always have to have a book on me. And I was gonna get through this one book, and then I was like, I want to make sure I've got another one, because I was in the Minneapolis airport doing this historic blizzard and got snowed in, and I'm like, what if I finish this book I'm reading and don't get another one? In fact, you can actually see, I just realized, I've got my boarding pass from that trip, and yeah, good times. Anyway, I picked this up knowing nothing about it, and funny enough, this, when I picked it up, it was like well over a year, it was like a year and a half ago, long time ago. Finally got around to it, you know, this week, and I'll just read the back and then we'll get started. In one terrifying night, the peaceful community of Creek's Cause turns into a war zone. Chance Rain, his older brother Patrick, and their close friend Alexandra find themselves fighting off multiple attacks from infected adults, while other young survivors hide at the high school. Most of the kids they know have been dragged away by once-trusted adults who are now ferocious, inhuman beings. The parasite that transformed them takes hold after people turn 18, and Patrick's birthday is only a few weeks away. Determined to save Patrick's life and the lives of the remaining kids and teens, the brothers embark on a mission to uncover the truth about the parasites, and what they find will change everything. Okay, so I picked this up. It sounded interesting. You know, a lot of times when you're at bookstores that are in the airport, you don't really get a huge selection, so I kind of just grabbed what I thought was entertaining at the time. And I just kind of kept putting this off. I sort of forgot about it because I ended up picking up a couple other books on that trip, and then this just ended up lurking in the back of my bookshelf for a long time, and then I just got around to it. And unfortunately, I was not a big fan of this. I probably am giving it 2.5 stars. I was definitely disappointed in it. And I think part of it, I kind of should have known a little bit better, even though I love just zombies stories, survival stories, parasite stories, plagues, contagions, all of that stuff. One of my big pet peeves in literature is this idea that, like, once you turn 18 that day, then some medical thing happens. Like, you'll get sick, you'll do this, you'll do that, because unfortunately, human body doesn't work that way. Things don't just, you know, on your 18th birthday just pop up, unless it's like a legal thing, like, you know, on your 18th birthday, then now you're an adult and that kind of stuff, of course, but they're arbitrary things. They're, you know, kind of like what I had issues with the Gone series by Michael, I think it's Michael Grant, and I read it when I was younger. Even when I was a teen, I was still like, but how come all the adults just, once you magically turn 18, you just disappear? And then there's like another book I remember reading as a kid where all the adults got sick, and there's just like this very distinct line between an adult and a child, when in reality there isn't. But I thought maybe that wouldn't be such a big deal. I don't know, I thought I could maybe get over it with this book, and unfortunately I did not, because essentially in this book, the rains, it's raining and it causes all the adults to go insane. And it turns out it's because of some kind of parasite. I don't want to do too many spoilers, but basically there's a parasite, like a fungus-based parasite. And then once you're 18, it just grows in your brain and then you go crazy. And I'm like, that doesn't work that way. And I do think too, so this book is called The Rains, and the main characters, their last name is Rain. And I'm like, oh, that's kind of the author being a little cheeky. Like, sometimes I appreciate that kind of stuff, but the more I read into this book, the more I was like, not having it. Especially too, the characters are like, so Patrick is like practically the perfect older brother. He's, you know, popular, other jock, and he's, you know, actually, I think he's a pretty good boyfriend, that kind of thing. But Chance, the main character, is kind of a weak character. It takes like 80% of the book for him to really kind of develop and become more, I guess. So I was a little bit disappointed in that. It's also kind of slow at times, like the beginning starts off fairly slow, and I don't necessarily mind a slow burn, but this one in particular, I was just kind of like, okay, let's get going, because I sort of wanted to just get into it because that was the kind of book I wasn't really expecting this to be as slow in the beginning. I kind of wanted to just jump right in. And there's just, that's the thing, it's like, it's entertaining. I was entertained by it. It got me through the whole end. And I did appreciate that it was fairly gory for a young adult book. I enjoyed that aspect where I'm like, wow, they're really going there. That's cool. There are some scenes that I really enjoyed. There's one scene where there's this guy on a water tower and there's like basically explosion, he explodes kind of, and you know, and they don't shy away from that stuff. And I thought that was really neat. That was exciting. Because I think that with young adult, you can still push the boundary a little bit more. Kind of like with one of my all-time favorite series, the Monstromologist series, you can push a little bit more, and I think a lot of young adult authors tend to shy away from that. But I liked that in this book. It was entertaining in that aspect, but there's just so many illogical things that happened that I'm just like, I just can't get over it. I'm sorry. I can try to suspend disbelief, and I'm usually pretty good at it, but with this case, I was just like, nah, I'm not happening. Just not really my cup of tea. But I suggest maybe you giving it a shot, maybe if you can suspend disbelief a little bit more and just kind of just go with it. Or maybe younger readers, maybe if I had read this when I was still in high school, I might have just ignored some of the things a little bit, but unfortunately that was just not the case. So it wasn't terrible. It wasn't like The Woods Are Dark, which was my first book review, and I was like, oh, this is a one star. This, you know, 2.5, it kept it going, even though there were some, like, weird point of view shifts as well, because it was going from first to third, but then all of a sudden, the first person point of view, I'm like, how did he know that? Because there was no way for him to know it, you know. So some stuff like that. So if you can just kind of try to suspend disbelief, you know, it can be entertaining. It is part of a series, or at least a duology. I know the other book is, that is called Last Chance. I won't be continuing with it though. I have so many books. My TBR pile is always just huge and growing, and I'm, you know, as I get older, I'm more like, you know what? I read the first one and I know I'm not going to continue, and I'm okay with that. I think that, you know, ultimately you should really try to read books that you think you're going to enjoy, and if you aren't having it, you know, you're not enjoying it, just move on. Yeah, so ultimately, That's a Rain, Gregg Hurwitz. Proceed with caution, and if you can just kind of ignore some stuff, maybe you might be in for a fun ride. Not sure. But anyway, thank you so much for watching my video. Please like, comment, subscribe. If you've read the book, let me know what you think. If you have any questions about it, let me know. And then I'll probably be posting a more spoilery review at some point in the future. But for now, thank you so much, and have a great day and happy reading!